Thank you. Reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Therefore, my beloved, just as you have always obeyed me, not only in my presence, but much more now in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who is at work within you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Do all things without murmuring or arguing, so that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God, without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation, in which you shine like stars in the world. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
And the rich he does. The Gospel according to Luke. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide the family inheritance with me." But Jesus said to him, "Friend, who sent me to be a judge or arbitrator over you?" And he said to them, "Take care. Be on your guard against all kinds of greed. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of possessions." Then he told them a parable. The land of a rich man produced abundantly. And he thought to himself, "What should I do? For I have no place to store my crops." Then he said, "I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, 'Soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this very night your life is being demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, whose will they be?' So it is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but are not rich towards God." He said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn. And yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to the span of life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these." Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Like your servants Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac, to see and to serve Christ by feeding the hungry, welcoming the stranger, clothing the naked, and caring for the sick, that we may know him to be the giver of all good things, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. From whom all holy desires all good counsels and all just works to proceed. Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ.
We, as usual, thank you for joining us in keeping the appointment here for Evensong once again on this very beautiful spring day. I think it must be the nicest day we've had since last October or so. So a day to be treasured for all of us Northern Ohioans especially. So thank you for being here. And since I have the floor for just a moment, I'm going to give a plug for our benefit concert for music and art at Trinity coming up this Monday night at 7:30 right here when we have harpist Parker Ramsey, who's a really terrific harpist, also a very fine organist, but he has really sort of staked his claim to the harp nowadays, and he's going to play the Bach-Goldberg Variations, which many of you probably know is originally a keyboard work, but he has made it a really convincing harp piece, and in the year 2000, just 2 years ago, 2020, he recorded it in the beautiful reverberant chapel of King's College, Cambridge, England, and that recording has gotten a lot of play and a lot of very favorable press around the country, so we're really lucky to have Parker right here to play it for us on Bach's birthday, Monday. So if you'd like tickets, they're easily obtained. You can go to the Trinity website. You can find out how to purchase tickets very easily, or you can go to the email music@trinitycleveland.org, music@trinitycleveland.org, and we'll get you signed up, or else just come Monday night, and you can make it work then. But at any rate, pass the word around. We hope you'll be here for what promises to be a very special evening on Monday. It's a special day for us today as well, because this is the first time in God knows how long, more than 2 years, that we've had permission from the vestry and the higher-ups to sing, as you may have noticed, without masks on. And it's a very different and wonderful world. So in addition to the beautiful day, it's a special red-letter day for us chorally here. And lastly, but not leastly, it's a very special day because we get to welcome our good friend Paul Gaston back to Trinity once again. So it's an absolute joy to have Paul here. I've been looking forward to it, and I suspect I'm not the only one to say that. So, Paul, thank you so much.
Lord, make us instruments of your peace. That familiar first line of a prayer attributed to St. Francis comes readily to mind whenever there is unrest, whether in our neighborhood, in our nation, or in the world. It is easy to offer the prayer. The question is how to live it. How can we serve as instruments of peace, especially when so many of the threats to peace are global? Ukraine, China and Taiwan, the Korean Peninsula. And when they are created by powerful men who clearly prefer power over peace. We will not leave Evensong this evening with an explicit how-to, but we may take away a few hints. We find these hints in the holy people that we remember this evening, Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac. We may find them in the reading from Luke that we heard just a few moments ago. It expresses values that de Paul and de Marillac exemplify. And we find them in the experience of Evensong itself. Evensong invites us to reflect on and give thanks for the examples of those who have gone before us. Not just because we should admire their accomplishments, but because their examples offer us guidance. When Vincent de Paul was ordained at the young age of 20, having been ordained at 56, I envy Vincent de Paul that. Ordained at the young age of 20, his gifts as preacher and pastor destined him for high office in the church. But he chose to focus instead on the needs of parishioners in small congregations. The religious community he created, the Vincentians, seeks priests and brothers who are willing to place just such needs ahead of their own ambitions. Later, a charitable organization, De Paul, founded to care for abandoned children in Paris, inspired the formation of an order of nuns, the Daughters or Sisters of Charity. In all that De Paul did, there was a common theme, which was that he cared more for others than for himself. The same can be said for his colleague, Louise de Marillac, co-founder of the Daughters or Sisters of Charity. Unlike religious orders that invite women to choose seclusion from the world, the Daughters attract young women who will dedicate themselves to ministry in the world. One example of which stands four blocks from this cathedral in that large hospital. In all that they continue to do, there is a sense among the daughters of this common theme. They care more for others than for themselves. And so both Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac express in their lives and ministries the truth taught by Jesus in our reading this evening, that we can serve him and our neighbors only if we choose not to make our needs our first priorities. Now, that should not encourage us to roll back in the Barca lounger and wait for others to provide us with the necessities of life. The disciples fished for their dinner. But Jesus says that we should not be anxious about life's necessities. Some cannot avoid that anxiety. I've known students in college worried about not having enough food. Nearly 20% of community college students experience some form of homelessness in an average year. But for many of us, Jesus's advice translates into our not making a fetish of food, as some do, or of stylish clothing, as others do, and reordering our priorities from our own interests to those of others, we live out Jesus' advice. The holy men and holy women we recall at Evensong, such as Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac, love God with heart and soul and mind, and they love their neighbors as themselves. And they show it in how they order their lives. With their examples before us, it is impossible to ignore the contrasts evident in our headlines. In Sunday's New York Times, an experienced Russian journalist describes the president of Russia as concerned only for himself, having, and I quote, having lost interest in the economy, social issues, the coronavirus pandemic. According to the commentator, these all annoy him. And so he has chosen to serve not as an instrument of God's peace, but as the instigator of an unprovoked war. So it is this evening that as we confront the news of Ukraine, as well as our own concerns about the economy and social issues and the coronavirus, and so we come to Evensong. We gather for music and reading and contemplation. We find a quiet respite in which we can separate ourselves from the headlines, find assurance in our faith, and consider how we might become instruments of peace. A few hints. We may do so by offering direct relief to the poor. Or we might find ourselves working for more equitable taxation, for universal health care, for access to high-quality education. As we avoid making a fetish of our own needs, we can become instruments of God's peace by supporting food banks and fair housing legislation. For many of us, world peace is going to begin at home. Mediating a dispute over the office water fountain, or finding a path to reconciliation with an annoying neighbor, or avoiding an angry exchange on the highway when confronted with careless or aggressive driving. It may also take the form of our helping one another through this difficult time, of contributing generously to Episcopal relief and development, and to maintaining contact with friends in Russia and Ukraine. Above all, we may understand that even now, as we sit quietly and pray for peace, for God's peace in that world, we are instruments of that peace. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray, in the hearts of all the true love of peace, and guide with your pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Amen. Please join me in prayer number 3, the night prayer from the New Zealand Prayer Book. Lord, it is night. The night is for stillness. Let us be still in the presence of God. It is night after a long day. What has been done has been done. What has not been done has not been done. Let it be. The night is dark. Let our fears of the darkness of the world and of our own lives rest in you. The night is quiet. Let the quietness of your peace enfold us, all dear to us, and all who have no peace. The night heralds the dawn. Let us look expectantly to a new day, new joys, new possibilities. In your name we pray. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.